episode 39 of the Redmont Rangers Road to Glory career mode, and we have possibly the most important episode of the series so far. I would definitely say the most important episode of season 2 so far. We face Rotherham in the first game of the episode here. Both teams want 3 points, as the news story says. The two teams seemed evenly matched when they last met, and that was reflected in the 1-1 scoreline. Rotherham United fans would be hoping to see their team go one better and win today's match. So certainly will Redmont Rangers fans. We can see Norwich actually beat Aston Villa 2-0. Was that in the... Will the news story load? Is that in the Cup? Carabao Cup? No, FA Cup. Aston Villa knocked us out of, I believe. Maybe Norwich City knocked them out in return. So, yeah, three important games to get to in this particular episode. We've got Rotherham away, which is a huge, huge game. Rotherham in second place. 14 points ahead of us, if I remember rightly. But I believe we do have a game in hand on them. So, yeah, one game in hand and they are 14 points ahead of us. We're probably not catching Rotherham, let's be honest. We're probably not getting up to those automatic promotion places right now. Certainly not catching Ipswich Town. Catching Rotherham, very unlikely as well. We do desperately need a win here, though, to claw ourselves back up into those playoff places. Three wins in this episode would be fantastic. We had three losses in the last episode. We lost to Portsmouth 2-1, to Wigan 3-2, and then to Bristol Rovers 3-1. And we can see we haven't actually had a win in more than a calendar month. Last win was on the 25th of January against Walsall. It's now the 7th of March. That is a really, really terrible run of form. And we've gone from a pretty solid playoff contender to down in 7th place. All is not lost, though. A win here against Rotherham can turn things around. We're going to debut the 4-3-3 formation. So let me just set Jake Dale as our captain. And we're going to run out. Roman Hewitt, Josh Key, Caleb Taylor, Jesse Cartwright and Nick Zaroya at the back. A midfield three this time. I think for the first time in this series. Of Brandon Anderson, Paris Magoma and Michael Garbutt. Lancaster, Dale and Just as the front three. A fairly standard bench. We've got Jasper... I keep wanting to call him Jasper Fields. I'm not sure if that's somebody or... I just keep making that name up. But the 16-year-old Jasper Shields is on the bench. Looks a really promising young prospect. Daniel Jefferson on the bench as well. Brett Gibbs, not really making the team at the moment. I might put him in for Walter, actually, just to give him a chance. Walter has been playing very well. But I think Gibbs deserves another chance to put his stamp on the team. We'll have a quick look at the pre-match report for Rotherham. They're going to play a 4-1-4-1, and they're going to set up fairly standard. Three key players, though. Humphreys in defence, and then Nombe and Tiehi in attack. Two wins out of the last five, two losses, and the one draw for Rotherham. So, should be a tough game. We are away from home. We are going to run out with our third kit as well. I still haven't really had a chance to use that away kit very much this season at all. It is going to stay for next season. It will be the home kit that changes next season. So we will get more opportunities to use that nice white kit next year. But for now, it's going to be the third kit as we take on Rotherham away from home. 100 games. As Creator Club team manager, brilliant. And good evening on what is a perfect night for football. The flood. Don't believe that's the name of our team. I'm pretty sure we are called Redmont Rangers, but 100 games in charge for Hans Neumann is a big milestone, and it really would be good if we could acknowledge that milestone with a win here. Really poor start from Rotherham. We give the ball straight to Michael Garbutt. Lays it off for Josh Key. Rotherham back in their shape now, but Ryan Lancaster has the ball. Crosses for Jake Dale, but doesn't find him. Much more positive start in this game compared to the last one, though. We had a really poor start when we played Portsmouth. And that ultimately, you would probably say, is what gave them the edge in the game. Bit more of an aggressive formation, this one. We press a bit higher. Try and win the ball back a little further up the field. Try and force the defence into those kinds of mistakes. Paris Mogoma has not been playing well. We had a message from Brentford, kind of complaining at the lack of playtime, but he's really dropped off in terms of form, Paris Mogoma, so they can't blame us too much for not playing him. He was very good early in the season for us, but level of play for Paris Mogoma has dropped off significantly in recent weeks. The same has to be said for a number of players on the team, though, so there's only so much you can do if the team around you is not performing. It's a poor pass from Brandon Anderson. We've got him in that CDM role more for his defensive prowess rather than his deep playmaking abilities, but you would have thought he could do a little better with that particular style of pass. Paris Mogoma's created a bit of space here, and he's going to get a shot on goal. It's blocked. The goalkeeper had committed to attempting to save it, so if we could get the rebound, we had an open goal there. Good block from Josh Key to stop the cross there. I was a little worried for a moment that Rotherham might be in for a goal there, but good block from Josh Key in the end. And it's a good run from Nick Zaroya. Paris Mogoma just unable to find him. It was a good idea and almost executed well, but not quite. Finds Eli Just on this occasion, though. Can't quite cut inside, but Paris Mogoma does pick up the ball again and spreads it wide to Ryan Lancaster. Josh Key on the overlap is going to find some space. Can't quite cross the ball before he's shut out by the Rotherham defence, though. Much better start from Redmont Rangers. I do like this 4-3-3 formation going forward. It's in defence where we're a little shakier. We do tend to win the ball back very high up the pitch, though. We've done it multiple times already today. Oh, and Ryan Lancaster just trying to forge a bit of space there to pull it back to Paris Mogoma. Ends up being squeezed out of play, and it kind of takes an awkward bounce off him and out for a goal kick. Paris Magoma's going to have to challenge for that. He doesn't want Nick Zaroya to come up. And we are still really lacking pace on the wings. I think that has to be priority one in the summer, whether we go up or not. We have to try and find a winger who's got just that real game-changing pace. Moving the ball more decently, but can they take the lead? It's an easy claim for Roman Hewitt. Stays on his goal line, just waits for the ball to come to him. Rolls it out to Caleb Taylor, who almost loses the ball immediately. Jesse Cartwright making a charging run forward, apparently, for some reason. It's a nice little ball slipped in behind from Paris Mogoma. Jake Dale's in space if we can find him. Eli Just's cross doesn't quite get there. Again, we're pressing high. Again, we're looking like we could win the ball back here, and Jake Dale doesn't quite manage to come away with it. Would have been so dangerous if he was able to. Eli Just comes away with it here, though. Big switch of play over to Ryan Lancaster, who's making the run. Cuts inside, but can't quite corral the ball again when he did so. Ryan Lancaster unable to find Jake Dale on that occasion. You can see we are committing a lot of players forward. I think this formation and this system is going to be better to play when we have a significant advantage over the team that we're facing. Oh, and that's a really poor clearance from Caleb Taylor. Puts the ball into more trouble than it would have been if he'd just let the ball go out of play for a corner. Fortunately for him, though, the shot is straight at Roman Hewitt. Oh, Eli just failing to get the ball on the first occasion. Manages to find Jake Dale, though. He's going to shoot with his right foot and it's going to go just wide. The goalkeeper left it. I think he was confident the ball was going wide. It wasn't too far off, though. Yeah, I think this formation and this system is going to be much better if we are the favoured team. The team that's going to have more possession in the game. That's going to really look to kind of dictate play. It's kind of a risk to play this way against Rotherham, but I think we need to get on the front foot. I think we need to try and be positive.
That's an important intervention.
And not quite chase the game, but, you know, try our best to put our stamp on it. I feel like we just don't have the options in the box for some reason. Jake Dale quite likes to set up on the edge of the box rather than, you know, gamble. That's a bad challenge. Just a yellow probably, and it is. Yeah, Jake Dale likes to set up for the pullbacks rather than to gamble on the near post for crosses. Daniel Jeberson a bit more willing to get across the goalkeeper and across the 6-yard box. It's a nice ball in from Eli Just. The ball cleared from Rotherham though. Nick Zoroya turns and shoots. Blocked without too much trouble by Rotherham. Ooh, Eli Just almost stealing the ball away high up the pitch there. Paris Magoma does... I was going to say Paris Magoma does just that, but he backed away from the ball for some reason. It was there to be taken. And he just chose not to take it. Jake Dale almost stealing the ball away, but Eli just manages to come away with it. Finds Ryan Lancaster. He's going to drive into the box. He needs an option. Eli just with the shot, which has blocked both. Michael Garber and Jake Dale have taken up the same position, and they both kind of got in each other's way there. We needed one to take up that position and the other to go across to the near post. Don't be offside, and he's offside. Come on.
The Rangers have possession again.
It's a nice ball from Eli Just. Ryan Lancaster's going to have to put it in early. Because I knew that was going to happen. Jake Dale with a header. It's blocked out for a corner. A goal just before half time would be fantastic. We've had the better of the first half, I would say. But we are rapidly approaching half time with the scores still level. It's a poor corner, really. It was far too deep. And we could be exposed on the counter attack here. Jesse Cartwright's coming over to try and put a stop to it, and it's a poor cross in the end from Rotherham. Harmlessly goes out for a goal kick. We've kind of been let off there. They should have caused us more of a problem than they did. It's a nice play down the left hand side from Redmont Rangers here though. Paris Magoma cuts back inside. There's just so little on ahead of him. He's going to have to find Ryan Lancaster. Cuts into the box, tries to beat the Rotherham player, and actually does in the end. Chips it back in for Jake Dale, who can't get there. Good challenge from Caleb Taylor. Josh Key on the overlapping run. There's Jake Dale in his usual position. We want him in the box, though. We really need him in the box, especially if he's the only striker. We'll recycle it once more, though. Find Ryan Lancaster out wide again. Tries to cut it inside to Michael Garbutt, but can't find him. It's a great challenge from Josh Key to put stop to that counter-attack. And a free kick! How on earth is that a free kick? That was a fantastic challenge. Perfectly timed. And at half time, that first half has gone very, very quickly. It's still 0-0. Rotherham created very little in that first half. We didn't create too many clear opportunities, but I definitely feel like we had the better of things. Don't really feel the need to make any changes at half time, I don't think. I'm keen to bring on Shields, Gibbs and Jeberson in this second half, so I might just go up to the attacking game plan for the first 5 or 10 minutes or so of this first half as well. The corner here would do, the cross into the box will do as well, either of those is a fine option. Good pressing from Ryan Lancaster, but the ball goes out for a Rotherham throw rather than a Redmont Rangers throw. Jake Dale there almost stealing the ball away again, high up the pitch. I think, to be honest, that might be our best chance of scoring, stealing the ball away from Rotherham in their own third. This is an awkward attack here. Ryan Lancaster and Jake Dale just trying to work something out between them on the left-hand side. A nice little ball from Ryan Lancaster into the box for Michael Garbutt, but the goalkeeper comes out bravely to collect. Thought the ball was just going to fall to the Rotherham player there. I would have been very frustrated with that. We managed to get deflection on it, but it looked for a minute as though it was just going to fall to the feet of the Rotherham player. Oh, Nick Zaroya, I thought he's just going to tap the ball out of play there. He didn't really need to try that hard to keep it in. Finally, we get players in the box, one of whom is Jake Dale, and the ball flashes wide. It's actually going to go out closer to a throw-in. Josh Key puts the ball in again, and Michael Garbutt heads towards goal. And again, the ball stays in play. Ryan Lancaster pulls it back. Michael Garbutt in some space manages to get a shot towards goal, but it's blocked. Not sure how he didn't not only score there, but didn't really manage to put a shot on target. It was good feet from the Rotherham midfielder who breaks away. We're going to have to be careful here. That ball inside was always on and they've taken the goal. That ball inside was always on. I could see it coming from a mile away. Could just do nothing about it. And that's an absolutely infuriating goal to concede. Caleb Taylor comes across, even though Brandon Anderson has got that covered. I'm using Brandon Anderson. I'm taking away that run. Caleb Taylor just needs to stay with the player. There's no need for him to come inside there. So we're going to have to make changes now. Shields is going to come on. Gibbs is going to come on. Jeberson's going to come on in a bit. We're going to leave Jake Dale up for now. Oh, that's such an annoying goal. I can see it coming from a mile away. I knew exactly what was going to happen. we could have some players in attack, that would be fantastic. Good pressing from Josh Key. Wins the ball back. The ball goes out for a Rotherham throw, but we have got them pinned deep. I'd like to keep them pinned deep here if we can. And it looks like we are going to be able to. Eli just strikes it goal, but it's straight at the goalkeeper in the end. He did well to create a bit of space to get the shot off. But unfortunately, the gap that he had to shoot through was one that led straight to the goalkeeper. Oh, and Jake Dale stolen the ball away. Doesn't quite manage to thread it through to Michael Garbutt there. I said that might be our best opportunity to score, stealing the ball away high up the pitch. And it looked as though Michael Garbutt was going to be through on goal there. Seeing here, I could just do with a player with some real pace to get away. Eli Just is not slow, but he just doesn't have that, you know, that game-changing pace to get away from the fullback. I need somebody with just blistering speed to just put the defender behind him. Eli Just never really able to properly pull away there. I just needed Jake Dale to cut it back onto his left and play the pass. He's trying to play it with his right. Jake Dale is so left-footed, he always plays the ball with his left foot. On that occasion, he just chose not to for some reason. I think Jake Dale's going to have to come off. It's frustrated me the last couple of games. Sanford's going to come on for Brandon Anderson as well. We need a bit more in midfield. A bit more creativity. If we lose this game, I'm going to be absolutely furious. And we're going to be 2-0 down here. It's a good save from Roman Hewitt in the end. I don't think Roman Hewitt's good enough for League One, much less the Championship. I think we're going to have to try and upgrade on Roman Hewitt. What I think I'm probably going to look to do... Great ball from Jasper Fields. What I think I'm going to try and do next season, regardless of whether we go up or not, is bring an experienced goalkeeper in on loan. Somebody who's up around the probably low 70s. Try and bring them in on loan. Have them play as our number one next season. Send Roman Hewitt out on loan. He does still have high upside. A lot of potential, but he's too young and inexperienced. He's not good enough yet to play. And we've seen that a number of times this season. He's been caught out. And we've been caught out as a result. It's not the case in this particular game necessarily, but it's got to be a goal, and it is. Sam Ford gets the equaliser. An ugly, ugly goal, but it's a goal nonetheless. Sam Ford with the captain's armband, now that Jake Dale has left the field, gets on the score sheet, silences the Rotherham fans. And take a look at the goal again. It was just a ball tossed into the box from Eli Just and then lobbed over from Michael Garbutt. I don't think the defenders or the goalkeeper expected that. And Sam Ford is free at the back post and just taps the ball in basically into an empty net. So we're going to go back into our balanced game plan. We are going to be pushing for a goal still, though. We're not just going to sit back and try and ride this one out. I really would prefer a win to a draw in this game. And there's still 15 minutes left to find that. I Going to have to get the ball back at some point, though, if we do want to find the win. Michael Garbutt manages to do that. He's just going to have to clear, though, and it hooks out of play. I was just looking for a big ball down the line there, just for somebody to chase, just to get it out of trouble, but instead we're pinned back deep. Good interception from Michael Garbutt, though. And an equally good challenge from the Rotherham player. Not sure how aggressively Rotherham are going to press for the winner here. Probably less aggressively than us, given their position in the table. It's a good ball from Jasper Shields up to Eli Just. Finds Daniel Jeberson, strikes first time at goal. Potentially, yeah, time to take a touch there. The goalkeeper saved the first time effort, and then by the time he found the ball at his feet again, Daniel Jeberson was in too deep a position to be able to cut it back on goal. Just ends up hitting the side netting. And the Rotherham player just runs it out of play, fortunately for us. Throw to Michael Garbutt, squares it for Sam Ford. He's going to have to act a little more quickly than that. Does manage to come away with the ball, though. Brett Gibbs just unwilling to support him. I find that so frustrating as well. I'm spamming run. There's a player in a perfect position to make a support and run, and they just refuse. They just stand and watch. Jasper Fields strikes at goal. Just opened up for him there. He had players to his left and to his right, but the Rotherham defenders were more worried about those passes than they were the shot. So Jasper Field decides just to take on the shot. Daniel Jeberson get in the box. Got like a 6'4" striker and he's running to the corner of the penalty area. Good interception from Sam Ford. Brett Gibbs comes away with it. He's really not the paciest player, and we can see that. Rotherham defender immediately back in position to recover. I really do think that's the biggest thing that we're missing in the side at the moment, and that's some blistering pace, and I think that's particularly apparent in this system. Daniel Jeberson, get in the box. Runs across the near post. Doesn't get there before the goalkeeper, though. I think that was 3 minutes of added time. Maybe a chance for one more attack if we can win the ball back fairly soon. Rotherham not really keen to let us do that, though. Yeah, it looks like they're content to just run the extra time out. Jasper Shields not content to allow them to do that, though. He steals the ball away and drives towards the Redmont box. Plays a great ball into Gibbs, who's taken a touch for some reason. I press cross there. He should have been crossing the ball in first time. And instead he takes a touch. Why? Oh, that's infuriating. We had a chance to cross there and possibly score with the last action of the game, and Brett Gibbs takes a touch. These players, man, honestly, I'm getting so frustrated with some of these players. What a ball from Jasper Fields, though. Absolutely split the defence in two. That's another really frustrating game. We've come away with a point against second place Rotherham, which isn't too bad, but we've doubled their number of shots. Oh, I really feel like that's a game we should be winning. Really hope those 2 points dropped don't come back to haunt us. Although we did go a goal down and had to equalise, I really do feel like that's 2 points dropped. I'm going to say this isn't the time to panic, but really, I mean, it kind of is. Hans Newman putting on a brave face, I think. We were resilient. We are having problems up front at the moment. Something's not working. We can be better than that. We might have to put Daniel Jefferson and Jake Dale up front together. Go back to that 4-4-2. I don't know. Something's not working. So, two games still to simulate in this episode. So, we have got a draw. And if we can get two wins against Oxford, and I've forgotten who the third game is going to be against, Fleetwood, then potentially it won't be too disastrous of an episode. I'm going to change things around a little for this particular game. Jefferson and Dale up front. I think we just have to put our strongest team out there and hope they can get it done, to be honest. I'm going to play Magoma over Anderson just because Brentford are moaning about the amount of game time he's getting. We're going to go with Cartwright and... Did we go with Cartwright? Bullock is 2 overall higher than Cartwright, but he's worse in almost every category. It's just defending that Bullock is better at, which, I mean, is pretty important if you're a defender, to be fair. I think that's the team we're going to go with. We're going to bring in Jasper Fields over Sam Ford and Maya Walter in ahead of Gibbs. But other than that, that's the team that we're going to go with. Against Burton Albion, we have to get a win here. We haven't had a win in so long. We need it here. We absolutely need 3 points on the table. And we get another draw. Even though... Oh, it's Oxford. I've been saying Burton. It's Oxford. Their badges look very similar, to be fair. Even though Oxford spent the last 25 minutes or so probably with added time with just 10 men. There's the Burton Albion badge. We still don't manage to come away with a win. It's another just single point. And we've dropped all the way down to 8th now. Manager rating dropping very low as well. It's not looking good for us right now. We really need to turn things around in this next game. Ooh, William Dennis, 750,000. I was going to say he has only 87% potential. 87 is obviously still very high. You generally look for potential in the 90s with these youth players. Jake Dale. He's kind of moaning here. Team spirit doesn't matter to you at all. The only thing that matters is the results, and as long as we're in games, you don't care about anything else. I mean, yeah, you've kind of hit the nail on the head there, Jake Dale. You might not like it, but we need results at the end of the day. We're trying to go up to the championship. The board expect us to get automatic promotion. So, to drop out of the playoffs is not great. And we do really need a win. I don't care about team spirit. If we win this game, team spirit can go to hell. And we do win the game, finally. We get 3 points with goals from Jake Dale and Josh Key. So, finally back on the board in terms of wins. A win, a loss, and a draw in this episode. I really feel like it should have been 6 points. Wait, no, 2 draws? Yeah, 2 draws. 2 draws and a win. So actually an unbeaten episode. I do feel like it should have been 7 points instead of just 5, though. Hoping we can turn things around. What did we do differently today? Probably not a lot, to be honest. The goals just went in and we didn't concede any silly goals of our own. And we're back up into the playoffs. So, not an entirely tragic episode. And actually, we have got a game in hand on Bristol Rovers in 7th. And we're 2 points ahead of them. So, not too bad at all. Still in the same position as we were with Rotherham at the start of the episode as well. So, 14 points behind with a game in hand. So the episode, not as disastrous as maybe it feels. I do really just wish we got that win over Rotherham. Stoke have come in with a bid for Jasper Shields. I'm not interested in letting him go just yet, though. He's just 16. We've only just promoted him. Although it's a championship club. And this is unreal. There's definitely a bug in this game now. Some update or something has ruined just player morale, I guess, is what it must be. Because Jasper Shields, having been a Redmont Rangers player 2 months, is now requesting a transfer. That's absolutely ridiculous. I've barely got to use him. He's set as rotation. It's not even like he's crucial. And he's been playing. We bring him off the bench almost every game. And start him occasionally. Yet he's unhappy with his playtime and is requesting a transfer. That's absolutely ridiculous. I'm going to have no players left at this rate. If you're not in the starting 11, you want to leave, basically. I mean, he's thumbs up for playtime. Oh, I really don't want to sell him. What exactly did he say? I think me not getting games is starting to damage my career. Yet there's a green thumbs up next to playtime. Oh, that's just so infuriating. Like, I scouted him. I signed him to my youth academy. I saw the potential in him and promoted him. And now he's just going to go to Stoke for no reason. Alright, it's going to be Hull City instead. Alright, we're at least going to try and rinse them for all they're worth. Oh, that's absolutely infuriating. I'm so excited for this player. He looks so good. 1.9 is not enough. And they won't even take 2.25. Oh, the whole goal of this road to glory was to build through the youth academy. And we just have to sell the players a month after we promote them if they don't start every single game and play every single minute, apparently. Oh, another really frustrating episode. Frustrating game against Rotherham. Frustrating draw against Oxford, even though we simmed it. A win against Fleetwood. And then we get hit with a transfer request from Jasper Shields. So, I mean, I guess we'll have to accept an offer in the next episode. We've got Blackpool, we've got Wickham, and we've got Charlton. And that's going to take us deep into April. How many episodes are we going to have after that? We're going to have one here, and then two here. So two episodes, three episodes left in total. It's all we've got left of this season. We're currently in sixth position. I don't think in the final nine games we're going to make up the 14-point gap that stands between us and Rotherham, even though we do have a game in hand. So it's going to be just trying to secure a playoff position and trying to go up to the Championship through the playoffs. So we'll decide which games we're playing in the next episode. I think it's probably going to be Blackpool, though, although Charlton, I believe, are in the playoffs as well. So yeah, Charlton or Blackpool. I think, considering Charlton are so far ahead of us, probably it's just going to be better to play Blackpool and try and secure fifth place, maybe. Maybe that should be the aim. Maybe even fourth with Portsmouth. I think probably we won't even catch Charlton at this point, though. So, yeah, we'll get to those three games in the next episode. Two massive, massive games against fellow playoff teams. And then one game against Wickham Wanderers as well. Really getting into the crunch time of the season now. So we'll look to continue playing well and getting results and avoiding defeats primarily in the next episode. So until that next episode, take it easy.